Welcome everyone to one more session from Edignite NGO. In this particular session, we are going to solve the most simple star pattern in C program. So if you want more such videos from Edignite NGO, please like this video and subscribe to the Edignite NGO channel right away. So this is our pattern. Okay, if this will be our pattern, let me zoom in a little bit. Okay, and over here in the comments, I will write the pattern code. Okay, so let me give comments. So comments over here. Okay, so this will be the star pattern. We will have one star at first line. Okay, one, and then we will have two, then we will have three, and then we will have four, then we will have five. Okay, and it will go on for a particular n. Okay, so this is for n equal to 5. Okay, this is for n equal to 5. Here we have 5 stars at the bottommost line. Okay, so this is the star pyramid. Okay, right angled star pyramid, we can see. And if we have 6 stars, okay, if user inputs n equal to 6, then we will have a pyramid of 6 lines. Okay, so this way, this is how we would just, let me just comment this particular thing out. Okay, so this is how we would print the pattern. Okay, but now how we are going to print it? Okay, how we are going to print it? Everything depends upon the user input, right? The number of lines depends upon the user input. So we cannot print this particular thing right away, like printing a star, then writing printf backslash n. So it becomes more tedious. What if the user inputs, okay, n equal to 100, then it becomes more tedious. So for that, we are going to apply for loop over here. Okay, so here, what we will do is, first of all, we will take input from the user. Okay, so int, okay, we will declare a number int a. Okay, and then we will scan it. Okay, you must be wondering, what is I'm going a little bit off track in between. What is the name of this particular theme? So this is Edignite NGO theme. Okay, so go to extensions and search for Edignite NGO. Okay, Edignite NGO, and you will get this particular theme. It has been made by the alumni of Edignite NGO, Prince Wordmaster. So do install this theme in your Visual Studio Code and use it. Please rate the theme if you liked it. Okay, so let us move back to our star pattern, and now we will scan it. Okay, so we will scan this particular n. Okay, we will scan this particular n. Okay, so let me just write scan f percentage d backslash n. Okay, let me just write it down over here. Okay, okay, so let me just write percentage d ampersand n. Okay, so it will take the integer value and it will store it in n. Okay, variable n. And now we will just wrap it in quotation marks. Okay, we'll wrap this particular d in quotation marks to avoid any errors. So here we have scanned the thing. Okay, we can also give hint to the user by printf. Okay, by typing printf, and we will write enter number of lines. Okay, so user will enter number of lines. So let me give a semicolon over here. Okay, and then we will print it. Okay, so first of all, we will have a for loop. Okay, we want number of lines to be printed. So let us start from I. Okay, for I equal to 1. Okay, I equal to 1. I less than or equal to 5. And I plus plus. Okay, I plus plus. And let us declare this particular integer as I. Okay, so I am declaring it over here in int i. Okay, so for I equal to 1, we will print the things. Okay, we will print out the things, printf and we will just print one star over here. We will print one star. Oops, it's a star. Okay, so we'll print one star and then we will print a new line. Okay, printf backslash n. Okay, printf backslash n, and we'll save it. So we have saved the code and now let us run it. Okay, so it's running. Enter number of lines. Okay, let me enter 4 over here. Okay, you see we have got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Oops, we have got 5 as we have till here. Okay, so it should be okay. It should be till n. Okay, it should be till n. And now let us print it. Okay, so here we will enter 4. Here we will enter 4, and this works well. This works perfectly well. We have 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. We have 4 lines over here, and now what we are going to do is, in the first line we want to print 1 star. Okay, in the second line we want to print 2 stars. In third line we want to print 3 stars. Okay, so when I equal to 1, print 1 star. When I is equal to 2, print 2 stars. Okay, when I is equal to 3, print 3 stars. So this calls for a new loop. Okay, this calls for a nested loop if you think upon it. So let j be equal to 1, okay, and j be less than equal to I. So less than or equal to I, and j will increment the value of j. We'll declare the value of j over here. Okay, so let us declare the value of j over here, and then we will initiate the for loop. Okay, we will move this particular part in the for loop. Okay, so let us move this part in the for loop. Okay, so the star will get printed. Okay, printed according to the line number. So if the line number is 1, then 1 star will be printed over here. If line number is 2, then 2 stars will be printed. Now after printing 2 stars, we want to move into the next line. Okay, we don't want to move in the next line inside this particular loop, but after printing 2 stars we want to move to the next line. So just after the completion of this for loop, we have printf backslash n. Okay, so this is the program. This is the simple C program, and we will run it. We will run it now. So let me give 5 this time. You see that it works perfectly well. It works as expected. Okay, we have 1 star and 1 line, 2 stars on 2, 3 on 3, 4 on 4, and 5 on 5 lines. Okay, I will again print it out. Okay, let me again print it out. So I will use 7 this time. Okay, we will have 7, and you see that 7 lines have been printed. Okay, so let us recap what happened actually over here. Okay, first of all we printed, okay, we gave the value of n to our compiler. Okay, now the compiler pointer went over here. It initialized I and it initialized variable j. Now it assigned the value 1 to I. Okay, now I was given value 1, then it was checked that if is value of I less than equal to n. Okay, in this case let us take 5. So is value of I less than equal to 5? No. So it is, yes it is. So do this, okay, execute this particular thing. Now the pointer went inside the second loop where j was equal to 1. Okay, and then it checked the condition, is j less than or equal to I? Yes, it is equal to I. So we need to print this particular star, and then the j value of j got incremented. Okay, so it got incremented to 2. Now this particular condition became false, so it went out of the loop. Okay, this loop broke, and over here this particular thing. Okay, so the cursor went to the next line. Okay, cursor went to the next line and then increased the value of I from 1 to 2. Okay, similarly it did. Okay, it iterated over this code for I equal to 2 till I equal to 5. So this was the solution to the most simple star pattern in C program. Yes, it is a very simple pattern, but it builds fundamentals for many star patterns that we study further in our C programming language. So that's it for this particular session. Let's meet in the next session with an exciting topic. Thank you, everyone.